Injuries are never a good thing, except for in the crazy world of wrestling. Then they can be just what the doctor ordered. No joke, injuries can be good. Take away the human element of it, though. We're going to take away the human element and just focus on a pure storyline wrestling thing because, yeah, it's sad. It sucks. You know, Rhea Ripley just lost her title due to injury, and it's like, how far could that have gone? How long could that have lasted? Who would have beat her? So we do miss out on that part of the storyline and the human element. So yeah, that sucks. But again, focus on the story, focus on making lemon into lemonade, and we have ourselves opportunity. And it's happened in the past. Look at Becky Lynch. A couple years back, she was the champion. She was on top of SmackDown. She was about to go into Survivor Series and fight Ronda Rousey, a top star, top superstar from the actual world of sports. And so she was about to have a moment. She goes on to Raw and gets punched in the face by Nia Jax. Her nose is all bloody. Her face is fractured and broken. And that image of her in the stands with the fans, bleeding, defiant, saying, "That the best you got?" That elevated her. And just like I said in yesterday's video, Becky Lynch became the best wrestler in the world. I'm not talking best female wrestler. She became the man in all of wrestling. Becky Lynch was the top dog for a little bit there. So much so that she carried that momentum into WrestleMania. First female main event of all time with Ronda Rousey and Charlotte Flair, of course. So props to them, even though I don't feel that Charlotte should have been part of that. And it would have been so much better one-on-one. But I digress. But for real, that injury, she was taken out of that Survivor Series match. And she used that time to come back just a month or two later. But she came back with a fire that we had not seen. That moment, that punch in the face, that injury woke something up inside her that just next leveled her. Her missing that match, she used that anger of losing that match to come back, to show a passion unmatched by anybody at that time, and it was great, it was amazing. So that injury to Becky Lynch totally brought her to mega stardom. What about the injury to CM Punk? So this one's kind of weird. It's a kind of like a butterfly effect. CM Punk got injured and it didn't really elevate him. CM Punk is at the same level. And unfortunately, he missed out on the main event of night one of WrestleMania because he was going to fight Seth Rollins. However, his injury allowed Drew McIntyre, the guy who like kind of did the DDT and got him the injury at the Royal Rumble, it allowed Drew McIntyre to claim that he injured CM Punk, he saved WrestleMania, and now he got to be the main event. His injury, CM Punk's, elevated Drew McIntyre to a point where Drew McIntyre had lost like 2 to 3 times to Seth Rollins, literally just a couple weeks prior. And he became such a new character that we all wanted to see that match again at WrestleMania. And when he won, we were all just like, yes, this is great. This is amazing. This is awesome. Drew McIntyre has really come into his own as this sarcastic, hypocritical, big man, powerful heel that feels like everybody's against him and that he just doesn't have good luck in this world. It's like a really tough Bret the Hitman Hart before he did the whole Canadian gimmick, and which was part of the whole gimmick. And then what else happened? Seth Rollins, because he's not fighting Punk, gets to go into the main event with The Rock and Roman. It elevates Seth Rollins. So CM Punk's injury actually elevates Drew McIntyre and Seth Rollins. But what does it do for Punk? Okay, so like I said, it made him miss out, and that totally sucks. Again, human element, we don't want anybody to actually be injured. But what does it do for Punk? It gets him a blood feud. He already had a really hot feud with Seth Rollins, and I think that can reignite whenever. But now he has one with Drew McIntyre. Let's say CM Punk wins the title at WrestleMania, and he goes on and he fights Drew McIntyre. It would have been cool. It would have been a nice little, you know, 1 month, 2 month little feud, and things would have gone off. But because of how it has played out, and Drew really taking the ball and running with it, he now has this blood feud. So when CM Punk does come back, he instantly goes against Drew, and that feud right there can carry on for 3 to 4 to 5 to 6 months, and just be an everlasting feud that these two are just always kind of side by side. Even when they're feuding with other people, they can always come back, because now there's true animosity, hatred, the things that have been said, the things that have been done. Like, for real, this CM Punk Punk versus Drew McIntyre, and then they fight. Then he goes off to Seth Rollins, but then Drew can reinsert himself, and just like I said in my WrestleMania 41 prediction video, we could have Seth versus Drew versus CM Punk. So this injury has actually given some long-term stability and storylines to CM Punk, which will elevate him even further and cement him, because, you know, you're only as good as your feud and your opponent. So CM Punk, you know, yeah, we want to hear him on the mic, but if CM Punk feuds with someone like Carlito, it's going to be like a one-month thing and not great. But you want to have someone that you actually hate. And CM Punk having a feud with Drew McIntyre with such animosity now, just totally, I am just salivating at witnessing the matches, the promos from both sides. It's great. So yeah, it sucks that he got injured, but there's a lot of upside to it. And so now let's talk about Rhea, who had to relinquish her title at 380 days, just like John Cena, actually. So 380 days is like a cursed number now, because John Cena and Rhea Ripley both had to give up the belt, and that totally sucks. John Cena came back, he got a huge pop at the Royal Rumble, made us forget that we hated John Cena, at least Madison Square Gardens forgot for about 2 or 3 minutes. But when Rhea comes back, she has opportunity, because Rhea, the fans, we want to cheer her. We know that she's above everybody in the women's division. She really is. Like, nobody can touch her right now. Becky Lynch hasn't been like that megastar that I talked about earlier in the video for a good couple years now, and she even just beat Becky Lynch at WrestleMania 40, and Becky is still like top tier female wrestler, great all time. But right now, it's Rhea's time. Rhea is like a cut above everyone. The only people that are close to her level, definitely Bianca will always be in the conversation. Charlotte, unfortunately, will always be in the conversation, but then again, Charlotte is a great wrestler and carries herself like a great wrestler, and we could have a trilogy of WrestleMania matches, because Charlotte beat her once and then Rhea beat her once, so we could have Charlotte come back and have that, but I would rather not, because I just don't like the Charlotte character anymore. And that's going to be someone who got injured, and when she comes back, I don't think it's going to affect anything. Her placement, Charlotte's earned her spot, but she's just not a character for me. Kind of like Bailey's not a character for me, even though I respect Bailey. I very much respect Charlotte. It's just, I haven't really enjoyed them for a while. But Rhea is like a heel that is being cheered. And if she hadn't been injured, she would have had to stay in Judgment Day. There's no reason to get her out. Do we cheer her? Do we boo her? Because Judgment Day is a heel faction. And it's like, so now Rhea, she can go away for 3 or 4 months, and maybe we break up Judgment Day at the time, because we have a built-in feud with Damian Priest and Finn Balor. Finn Balor could be like, you know, when I kind of came in, I was kind of positioned as the leader, and now you're the champion, I'm the veteran, you should listen to me, I should get it. And then all Judgment Day can break apart, with Dominic kind of in the middle and just saying, you know what, I can't choose, I'm out of here. Or you can keep Judgment Day together. Rhea Ripley comes back, but she's different now, right? She sees things a little different. She doesn't think we should cheat as much. Dominic Mysterio, maybe he's got himself a new girl. Who knows? Someone kind of been snuck in, whispering in his ear, and he's just like, oh, she's just a friend. Don't worry about it. You're still my mommy, but you can tell that it's not. And Rhea's just kind of getting, she's not really jealous, but she is kind of like, you know, Dominic is putting this girl above her, so she is kind of getting a little slighted, and then she's just like, you know what, I don't want this, and that, and during some match, Dominic costs her the match, and we have a full breakdown, because we can't have Rhea Ripley with Dominic Mysterio. Those two have to be done. Dominic is too much of a heat magnet to have face Rhea. We gotta split him up. We really gotta split him up. Rhea Ripley, she's a crucial part of Judgment Day, but Judgment Day needs Rhea more than Rhea needs Judgment Day. Maybe that wasn't in the beginning, and Judgment Day did elevate Rhea to this level, but right now, Rhea's above Judgment Day. She's above almost everybody, right? Even, and when she does come back and she does become the women's champion, I don't know who's gonna top. It's gonna have to be Jade Cargill in 2 years, because Jade's the only one with the presence of Rhea, but she doesn't have the ring talent, so Jade needs some training too. Going back though, another reason why this is great for Rhea is because the chase man, who's gonna beat Rhea? Nobody, absolutely nobody was gonna beat Rhea Ripley. So now the title is no longer hers. She has to chase for the belt. She has to overcome the adversity of losing Dominic Mysterio and her Judgment Day friends, because she no longer feels that's how she should act or who she should be with or who she should be. And then she can chase the title, and then she'll win it, and she'll have a good long face
title run.
And yeah, this is great. We can cheer for Rhea without feeling bad that we're cheering for Dominic Mysterio in kind of a way. She no longer will be associated with them, and this fully breaks them apart. And yeah, it sucks that Rhea Ripley lost her belt this way and that she's actually hurt. I'm sure it really sucks, but Rhea, do what Becky did. Think about the situation and turn it into the best career move of all time. It's right there in front of you. We acknowledge you, Rhea, as the top female wrestler in the business. You're above everybody else. And I hope as we acknowledge Ripley, you acknowledge my subscribe button. I appreciate every single one of you. And Rhea, now's your time. Do it. Make it happen. Grab that brass ring and shove it down everybody's throat. Have a good day.